What if I told you that a student, a child, let's put them up, was bullied. School did nothing about it. The school has now admitted they messed up. He's bullied and he takes his own life because the school chose to ignore it. Keep the picture up. The Lawrenceville School, which is a prestigious New Jersey boarding school, is finally admitting they did not do enough to protect this teenager in their custody and care, named Jack Reid. Jack was 17 years of age, a student who took his own life on the campus after false and vicious rumors spread on that campus that he was a predator. Okay? Sounds familiar? Same rhetoric that conservatives are pushing around this country. Now it's contextualized inside of a school and a young man ended his life. Reid arrived at the boarding school in the fall of 2020 as a sophomore, befriending classmates and winding up honored on the dean's list. He was doing well. But the following spring semester, a rumor that he was a predator began spreading like wildfire through the student body. Despite the rumor, Reid returned to the school in September 2021 and was elected president of the residential housing where he lived. But the teen's new role only increased the rumors and bullying, his parents believe. Why? Because he's now in a leadership position. Okay? Reid, 17-year-old child, was continually harassed by students in person and by anonymous postings online, causing the unvetted rumor to spread outside of the school grounds. That's according to the outlet. A classmate previously disciplined for bullying Reid and determined to be involved in spreading the lies, the rumors about him. Well, that student was eventually expelled for an unrelated incident, the school revealed. In a statement as part of the settlement agreement, Lawrenceville declared that its students' physical, social, and emotional health, safety, and well-being are their top priority. The school, which is among the highest ranking and most sought after boarding schools in the country, seeks to improve as a community. We have examined our role and take responsibility for what we could have done differently. We recognize that in Jack's case, we failed tragically short. The statement read, put up the headmaster. Okay? Stephen Murray is the head of the Lawrenceville School, where the tuition cost $76,000. It is located just 5 miles south of Princeton. Before his death, Reid had approached school officials to intervene about the false rumors, prompting an investigation into the bullying and sexual assault. The school found, according to them, no evidence supporting the rumors and allegations about Reid being a predator, a fact that the boarding school did not acknowledge in public or in private, according to the outlet. They could have defended them, they did not. Though the facility was aware of the ongoing bullying, this elite boarding school has only now admitted failure 1 year to the day after Reid's death. Neither Reid nor his parents were informed that the school had cleared the teen of the claims before his death. We feel like we both have life sentences without the possibility of parole, Elizabeth Reid told the New York Times. In the heartbreaking admission, the school believes Reid's death could have been avoided if the situation had been adequately addressed, saying there also were circumstances in which the involvement of an adult would have made a difference. Look at that. So while the school gets to pay a bunch of money come out with an apology. Put him up, he's dead. This kid could have been a remarkable leader in whatever industry he chose to be in. But this school decided to care more about its fragile reputation. If this comes out, I mean, we may have a decline in interest for our prestigious institution. We know these are lies about him, but we're not going to say anything. We're not going to clear him. We're not going to be responsible adults, and it led to the death of that young man because of rumors that were allowed to spread. I want to say this. A wise man told me a story one time about what we say, what we repeat when we decide to viciously harm another person. He told me the story about a priest who lived in a community, small community. It was a big warehouse where everybody worked and everybody wanted promotion at this warehouse. There were two neighbors. One neighbor wanted a promotion. The other neighbor wanted that same promotion. So what happened? Well, one of them decided to spread a vicious rumor about the other. And he put this rumor out because he wanted that promotion and he did not want his neighbor to get it. So he lied on his neighbor. He knew he had a small town. He knew people would believe him. He has decent credibility. So he lies on his neighbor. So much so, the man does get what he wanted. He gets his promotion, but his neighbor gets fired. His neighbor then loses his house, family, children, wife, homeless. So now the man who got what he wanted by spreading lies goes to the priest. He says, I want to change what I did. What can I do? I didn't want this to happen to my neighbor. I just wanted a promotion. The priest says, here's what you do. Get a sack of feathers and put it in a pillowcase and put a feather outside of the doorstep of everyone you told this lie to. Well, naturally, the man said, this is an insane remedy, but he's desperate and he chooses to do it. And he does it all night. He gets feathers. He puts it in a pillowcase, puts it on every doorstep. That night, he goes to the priest. He says, priest, I did exactly what you said. Will everything be restored? The priest said, you got one more thing to do. Take this same pillowcase. And I need you to go and pick up every feather that you put out last night and just put it back in. The man says, priest, I can't do that because you see, as I slept, the wind blew the feathers all over the town, even outside of it. There's no way for me to put these feathers back. And the priest says, so it is with your words. Young man should be alive. Rickey, thoughts?
You're absolutely right. It should be a price to pay for just being low down. That is just absolutely sad. The school should be held liable. The school board should be held liable. And then they need to start leashing out harsher punishment to kids and parents who bully, especially if it costs another child their life.
That's right.
Needs to be accountability. Parents need to sit down and have a conversation with their kids about bullying. And I'm talking about juvenile.
Yep.
You know, juvenile. Because if somebody take their life because they're being bullied and they're too embarrassed to go to school and life becomes too much for them because of how they're being treated. And if you can prove it with tweets, emails, Instagram, whatever, that you're part of that, it should be some accountability in place, and people should be punished for their action because, hell, what's the difference between that and them shooting somebody? What's the difference?
That's right. The result is the same. The life is gone.